Okay, we're gonna talk about hi, Mr. T. We're gonna talk about how to connect this rope. I'm gonna show a bank robber knot, and I'm gonna show how to make a rope, how to connect your rope, your lead rope, to make it into reins on a rope halter. And I've seen a lot of different knots done this way. The knot I'm gonna show you isn't the only way. I think it's the best way. It's easy, it's secure, and it doesn't tighten up, so you can untie it easy. So what I'm gonna do first of all, Mr. T, see buddy picked up the, he got into some stuff over there and made Mr. T nervous. So Mr. T got nervous and he decided to start lunging. And somebody right now would be like, you need to make that horse listen. That horse is disrespect. This horse ain't doing nothing. He wanted to walk off, relieve a little stress and energy. Buddy kind of spooked him a little bit, and I let him walk a few circles. Everything doesn't have to be a fight with a horse. People want to have too much control. That horse should stand. I'm going to get some comment, like I got on, I don't know how many comments on Buddy. That horse is disrespectful. He doesn't respect his space. Blah, 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 blah. Shut the hell. I don't care about what you think my horse is disrespectful. I'm telling you, I have a relationship with my horses. We understand each other. I allow them to do things. I know and I'm confident enough that if I don't want them to do something, I know I can stop them. I don't have to prove it every second of every day to my horse that I'm in charge. He knows I'm in charge. I'm not holding Mr. T with some grip. Where's my gloves? I want to handle this horse. I got to get some gloves on so I don't burn my hands. If you're burning your hands, you ain't handling the horse right. Ain't no sense in grabbing and doing all this. You should be able to control your horse loosely and lightly and comfortable if your horse respects you and you know what you're doing. Of course, if you don't know what you're doing, then you need your gloves and you need your $75 stick with whosever name you want on it or whatever else you need. This is sell line, it's rope. I discussed this. This is the best rope I think to use for horses. It's made to work in salt water, so when a horse sweat, their sweat and salt doesn't mess it up. It's strong because it holds big sails on sailboats. It's flexible, it's easy to tie, it's easy to work with. If I throw it or move it, it falls. It's got what I call feel. These cheap ropes that everybody wants to go get that are pink and green and they're made of this nylon and they're stiff as a stinking board and people are trying to tie them and you can't even bend the rope in half because it's so stiff. The biggest bend you can get is maybe this. And it's, if you take shortcuts on your ropes, you're going to have a problem tying these knots or securing a horse properly with good knots. And then when your horse pulls, because the rope isn't soft and flexible, it's hard to get untied. So then you end up cutting it or tearing it, but because it has a fancy, nice brass, silver, gold buckle or whatever else, don't waste your money. If you put money on the front end and buy good rope, you'll never have to buy another rope again. A good sail line you can order online at any sailing shop. Pick your diameter, pick your color, pick your strength. It's got a nice cotton lining on the inside. It's good nylon, strong, but it's flexible and I can tie it and I can manipulate it. And I can control it when I throw it, and it's soft, and it's not, it just makes it a lot easier working with your horses. So I'm going to tie this on Mr. T. If I want to go riding right now, because I have rope halter, I can tie him, and then I can put this around his neck and make this into a halter. And again, this isn't the only way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this loose end, and I need to connect it to this rope halter so it becomes a reins. And I've seen some crazy running through here and run it through there and loop and tie and then through it. Look, I think my knot's pretty simple. You take the loose end, you wrap it around one time, and the second time you come over the top and you come straight down. So when I pull this, it tightens, and when I pull this, it tightens. And that's my knot. And people are like, that don't look too secure. That looks like it. The more I pull on this, the tighter it gets. So once this is secure, this is how I secure my knot. Now I have reins on my horse and I can go riding. And if I've done my homework and I've ridden my horse with one rein, like I tell you, it doesn't really matter if this comes undone anyway. My knots never come undone. I've never had it come undone. But somebody's out there gonna be like, I tried your knot, Rick, and it came undone and my horse ran away and it bucked me up. Look, if you know how to ride your horse with one rein, doesn't matter if it comes undone. Doesn't matter if your bit breaks, or if your snap breaks, or if your fancy leather with somebody's special name on it snaps because it gets dry rotted, doesn't matter. You know how to ride your horse with one rein. You have confidence to control your horse, to stop your horse, and to ride your horse with one rein. Which is why I say, ride your horse with one rein. Learn how to ride him with it on this side, learn how to throw it over and ride him with it on the other side with one rein, learn how to throw it back and ride him over on this side with one rein. That way, no matter what happens, as long as you got one rein, you can always still control your horse. So I'm going to tie this knot again. This is, again, all I'm doing is I'm looping once, twice, and then I'm going back over this rope with the loose end, pulling straight down. Didn't make that long enough for the demonstration here. Once, twice, through and down, and that's my knot. And I do that right on this knot. Now if I do it here, it's just gonna slide around because it's a slip knot. So I do it right around this knot up here, but I just did it lower so you can see it. So again, I'll do it again. It unties easy and it ties easy. I come around, I loop once. On the second loop, I come over this rope and I go straight down both loops. Then I tie this one tight and I pull on this one to make it tight. And that's my knot. And it's not gonna come undone. And when I want to take this off, what do you see, Mr. T? When I want to take this off, it's very easy because all I do is slide this out. It makes it loose. I pull that out and I'm loose and I'm ready to tie my horse with one rein. I do it one more time. People gonna watch this. Rick, you did it too fast. The person filming wasn't right. But look, I'll do it again. All I do is I loop it once, twice. I come around on top of the other rope and then come straight down. I pull down, I pull on this, I pull down, I pull on that, I tighten it, and there's my knot. That's how you connect a rope halter. It's pretty simple. I think it's simple. Again, like anything with horses and you, the more you do it, the simpler it gets. First time you tie this rope halter here, everybody's like, Rick, I can't get it. Do I come here? I don't remember, and you were doing too. Look, if you do it 10 times correctly, it'll start sticking, and it becomes second nature. It's very quick, it's very easy, and you can tell by looking at it if it's tied correctly. I can tell by looking at any rope halter that's not. I can tell if this rope halter is connected correctly for a reins, because when I look at it, I'll see one loop, I'll see the second loop that comes over down the middle of both of them, and then when I tighten these, I'll know it's right over this knot, and I see this little rope right here hanging down, so I know that's right, and I see this coming back, and I know that's right. And that's how I go riding all the time. Never had this come undone. No matter how hard I pull, all it does is tighten and tighten and tighten, and it's not gonna come undone. But to untighten it, all I do is loosen it up a little bit, comes off nice and easy, and I'm good to go. Again, I've seen a million different ways to do it. I think this is easiest. Done it three or four times, I'll do it one more time. Now I'll get a complaint. Dude, what do you think, we're stupid? You did this six times, I got it on the third time. I'm gonna do it one more time. All right, Mr. T, we're training these humans, bud. Just bear with me. We're going to come once, twice. I'm going to go over and down both loops. Tighten there, and that's my knot. And that's how you secure reins for going riding. Again, if you've done your homework, you're not going to worry about that coming untied anyway because you're ready in case it does, because you can ride with one rein and you're confident in your riding. So we'll make this one tape on how to connect a lead rope to a halter for riding. We'll end that there. Hope that helps. Mr. T, you're a good boy.